Welcome viewers, welcome to AP's 5 minute ophthalmology pulse. Watch, understand and remember anything in ophthalmology in under 5 minutes. Today we will talk about pigment lines in the cornea. The first we will talk about is the KF ring. It's a ring of copper in the cornea. As you all know, this is seen in Wilson's disease. It's also seen in Charcosis bulbi, which is a condition seen with an intraocular foreign body with a copper alloy. A pure copper foreign body having copper greater than 85% produces severe sterile endophthalmitis and can lead to phthisis bulbi. So, Charcosis is seen only when there are lesser quantities of copper. You all know that the cornea has got 6 layers. In the KF ring, the copper is deposited within the Descemet's membrane of the cornea. What is the nature of this KF ring? It is greenish brown or golden brown in color. This color is because copper is deposited as a granular complex with sulfur, which gives the ring its characteristic color. And it extends from the Schwalbe's line, that is the termination of Descemet's membrane, to about 5 millimeters inwards. So basically it's in the periphery of the cornea, bilateral because it's a systemic disease, seen first superiorly, then inferiorly, and then it extends to the rest of the cornea. In well-established cases, it can be seen even with the naked eye, but in early cases, slit lamp is required for diagnosis. Here in the slit lamp picture, you can see that the epithelium, nothing, stroma, nothing, but in the Descemet's membrane, you can see the brownish pigmentation. This slit lamp also shows the lenticular opacity, that is the sunflower cataract of Wilson's. Neither a sunflower cataract nor a KF ring are visually significant. And it's seen in up to about 50-60% even of asymptomatic patients. So if you see a KF ring, you'd like to work up a patient for Wilson's disease. It's present in a greater percentage of patients with liver disease and in almost all patients of Wilson's with either nervous system and or a psychiatric manifestation. And according to Sternleib, presence of KF ring along with a ceruloplasmin level of less than 20 milligrams for deciliter is diagnostic of Wilson's disease. Now, it is found that KF rings tend to disappear slowly over a couple of years in more than 80% of patients who undergo decopperizing or chelating treatment. Usually disappears first in the horizontal meridian and then in the vertical meridian. It may reappear with disease progression or if the patient is not compliant with treatment. So you can use this to monitor a patient's compliance. And apart from Wilson's disease and Charcosis, KF rings can also be seen in other liver disorders, especially those with a cholestatic component like primary biliary cirrhosis, neonatal hepatitis and cryptogenic cirrhosis, and also in disease conditions where there's an increased level of copper in the body like multiple myeloma, pulmonary carcinoma, benign monoclonal gammopathies, chronic lymphocytic leukemia and oral contraceptive use. Of course, these are not very common, but if you see a KF ring and there is no evidence of Wilson's disease, you might going to look into some of these causes. Next, we'll talk about the various ion lines in the cornea. Why do ion lines occur? Now, whenever there is a topographic abnormality, there is pooling of tears adjacent to the area of elevation. An ion that is normally present in tears gets deposited in the epithelium of the cornea, giving rise to various ion lines. In keratoconus, you get the Fleischer ring. It is a ring of hemosiderin present at the base of the cornea, and it might be either partial or complete. And its main clinical relevance is in the diagnosis of subclinical keratoconus. So if you see a Fleischer ring, and especially if it's combined with another finding like thickened corneal nerves, then you're sure that your diagnosis of keratoconus is correct. And if you're evaluating this person for a potential keratorefractive surgery, then you would not like to go in for a corneal thinning procedure such as LASIK. And in mild cases, you might have to look at it with either red free or a cobalt blue light prior to the installation of fluorescent. The next ion line we see is the Stocker's line. This is present in front of the apex of the pterygium. It is seen in slow-growing pterygia because only in this condition do you get pooling of tears long enough for an ion line to form. The Hudson-Staley line is seen in elderly individuals. It's quite ubiquitous in occurrence, and it is a horizontal present at the junction between the upper two-thirds and the lower two-thirds because this is the line of eyelid closure, and it's pathologically very similar to that of a Fleischer ring. Ferri's line is an ion pigment line present in front of the filtering bleb following trabeculectomy surgery. Pigment lines can be seen anterior to sutures in keratoplasty. They can be present following keratorefractive surgeries like LASIK. And in 80%, more than 80% of people who undergo radial keratotomy, iron pigment is seen in the form of a star. And this is referred to as a tear star. Of course, radial keratotomy is obsolete today. And pigment lines can also be seen anterior to the any type of corneal elevation, example, Salzmann's nodular degeneration. So that's it for today. I hope you found that useful. If you like what you saw, please give this video a like, subscribe to my channel, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update from AP's 5-Minute Ophthalmology Pulse. Please leave a note in the comment section if you wish for any particular topic to be covered in future. Look forward to weekly updates. Thank you for watching.